Hi, my name is Beth Philman, and you are watching the Choir Baton YouTube channel. Today, I'm going to be talking to you about why I started using tuning forks in the high school choir classroom and in private study with singers, even down to kindergarten. Okay, so let's talk about why tuning forks. Well, in the last couple schools that I taught in, it was weird that I had several students with perfect pitch. Now, I don't have perfect pitch, and it was incredibly intimidating for me as a teacher to have some students that had perfect pitch, but it also made me be a stronger teacher musician as well. And then it also enabled me to teach my singers that they did not have to rely on these students for pitches. Because what I found was when I was having singers do smaller sessions and breakout sessions on things, that they were relying on the singers with perfect pitch as if they were like a human piano. And that was unacceptable to me. Simultaneously, I was also assigning more activities for them to rehearse and even just sing a simple scale outside of the classroom. And not every student, in fact, the majority of my students did not have any experience working with a musical instrument. So going home and playing a piano to find their starting pitch was just not working. I wanted them to be able to have some sense of ownership in this process on their own. So I bought super cheap tuning forks off of Amazon, and every kid got one. And it first taught them that they needed to know how to listen and just replicate the pitch that they could do. Now, I chose A440 because I always had singers start in a D major and B minor scale when we were doing any type of solfege warm-ups. I also found that using A as an anchor pitch within the context of D major or B minor really worked well within a lot of the different keys we were singing in. So if they could get their starting pitch as sol, sol, mi, do, do, ti, la, they could then understand how to sing a D major scale, a B minor, natural, harmonic, and melodic scale, and then eventually chromatic and whole tone scales, just because they had a tuning fork and they could practice it on their own. It's an amazing tool that you can give singers to start using these. And it's incredibly intimidating as a teacher if you never had one. If you had just enough piano skills to be able to go over and plunk out a part or plunk out your starting pitch. But real life, y'all, that's not our case, particularly if your students are singing and rehearsing outside of the classroom and online or offline without you. I highly, highly encourage you, invest in the couple bucks for every tuning fork. Give it to a student. I still remember the day when they all got theirs for the first time. They thought it was the coolest thing. They wanted to take it all around the school building. And side note, the science teachers loved it because they actually talked about tuning forks in their science lessons as well. Hashtag cross-curricular. My name is Beth Philliman. You're watching the Choir Baton YouTube channel, and this is why I started teaching my students how to use tuning forks.